False ego, there are two kinds of false ego, godless ego and godly ego. So, godless ego means atheism, and godly ego, when ego plus spirituality, together if you mix, ego is not completely purified and still person is practicing spirituality. Then comes variety of theism. Variety of theism means what? Atheism means that I godless ego, I don't accept God and therefore I am the enjoyer, I am the proprietor, I am the controller. That is godless ego. Theism, there are so many branches of theism. Why? Because I am the enjoyer, I am the proprietor, but I want to enjoy and proprietor and control by help of God. So that's why there are some process of yoga. They go to Himalayas people and they do austerity, and so that they can get some power by the help of God. They get some siddhis, and after that, what they do? Control. They want to control people. They want to sow magics. They want to sow people, and the people are so mesmerized that they forget God and they are running after Him. So this is also ego, false ego. That's why it's called godly ego. So that's why in Gita, Krishna explains so many yogas, yoga system. But purpose is to control and enjoy, but not serve God, and therefore dissatisfaction. Because the purpose is, even if some people are following theism, path of God, their desire is to enjoy for themselves, therefore they are dissatisfied. So, real and ultimate yoga is Isa Vasyam Idam Sarvam. Everything belongs to God, so being honest, engage everything in His service. That is called Isa Vasyam Idam Sarvam. That everything belongs to God, we should use it for His satisfaction, His service. So that's why I said Bhakti Yoga. That is ultimate yoga. There are various varieties of yoga. Why I took up the topic Bhakti Yoga? I don't want to go into the detail of so many godly egos, where people are performing spirituality also for the sake of their own satisfaction, own enjoyment only. I do some yoga so that I remain healthy and then I should enjoy. But ultimate purpose of that yoga is to enjoy only. Yes or no? Because I ate too much pizza, my stomach is, you know, has become bad, and therefore I will do some yoga, and once my stomach is good, then again I can eat pizza. That's okay, but not the best. Not the highest purpose of yoga. This is the highest purpose of yoga, what explains in Bhagavad Gita.